What's good?
It's your favorite new channel to come to for hip hop news and content. The J Cannon's 518 Cents channel. Real quick, 508 gang, you already know the drill. That's why I love y'all so much. The rest of y'all, I'm gonna need you to do your boy a solid. Like, share, subscribe, comment. I definitely would appreciate it. But let's get straight to it, y'all. If you've been paying attention to the news lately, on top of Casanova getting indicted by the FBI, your boy G Herbo did too in Massachusetts, and he ended up going to court, which I used to live out there and I got family out there, so I figured who better to cover it than your boy JK. We're going to do the same thing we did in the Casanova story because it seemed like y'all liked that. I'm going to read you some of the details in regards to the case. The rapper G Herbo, his promoter, and others have been charging a scheme to use stolen credit card information to pay for trips on private jets, exotic car rentals, luxury vacation rentals, and designer puppies. G Herbo, who was named this week to Forbes 30 Under 30 list, Antonio Strong, a Chicago music promoter and manager, and several associates were charged in federal court in Massachusetts with conspiracy to commit wire fraud and identity theft. Strong, whom a judge called the ringleader of the $1.5 million fraud scheme, also faces a wire fraud charge. Others charged include Joseph Williams, another Chicago rapper known as Joe Rodeo, and Rockstar Rody. Court documents were unsealed this week, less than a month after G Herbo, whose real name is Herbert Wright III, appeared on The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon to perform the song PTSD with Chance the Rapper. An email seeking comment was sent to a lawyer for G Herbo on Thursday. No lawyers were identified in court documents for other defendants. No hearings have been scheduled. Authorities say Strong, G Herbo, and the others used text messages, social media messages, and emails to share account information taken from dark websites in order to bankroll a lavish lifestyle. In one case, Strong ordered two designer puppies for G Herbo using a stolen credit card and fake Washington State driver's license. According to the indictment, when the Michigan Pet Shop asked to confirm the purchase with G Herbo, Strong directed him to do so through an Instagram message, and he did. Authorities said the stolen credit card information was then used to arrange for a car service to pick up the puppies from the pet shop and take them to Chicago. According to the indictment, Strong also used the stolen account information to pay for the chartered jets to fly G Herbo and others from Chicago to places like Austin, Texas, and a private villa in Jamaica for G Herbo. Authorities said the scheme also included fraudulent payments for commercial airline flights, private chef and security guard services, and limousine rides, authorities said. G Herbo released his debut mixtapes, Welcome to Phasoland and Pistol Pete Project, in 2014. Both of them named for friends who had been killed in Chicago. Over his career, G Herbo has detailed his experiences of the far east side of Chicago in a neighborhood dubbed Terrortown, covering topics including post-traumatic stress, gun violence, drug use and sales, and most recently, fatherhood. G Herbo recently started a program in Chicago called Swerving Through Stress, aimed to give urban youth tools to navigate mental health. Basically, that was everything that happened in court with G Herbo, what's going on, why he got charged, why he got arrested, how they got him. Basically, social media was his downfall. I've been trying to tell you, y'all can't be doing dirt through social media. They track all that stuff. To be honest, I'm pretty sure the FBI got like a percentage in Facebook or Instagram, one of those apps. Like, y'all gotta realize, everything you put on social media can be used against you in a court of law. Whether it's lyrics, posts, pictures, videos, it can all be used against you. That's why this self-snitching stuff is at an all-time high. And he didn't even self-snitch, to be honest. Basically, to me, it looks like his manager got him jammed up. I don't know if G Herbo had an idea exactly of what was going on, or if his manager just told him, hey, yeah, say yes and yes, because I'm trying to get you this service and that service. And then he messages them on Instagram, which basically implicates him. And then now he's charged up in all this credit card fraud. They was basically using it to fit the bill for the lavish lifestyle that they live on the road, touring, going in jets, living in five-star hotels, five-star rentals, that whole good life y'all see on Instagram. I'm not saying that G Herbo don't really got money and can't afford to live that lifestyle, but this goes to show you a lot of the stuff you see with rappers and these entertainers, It's all smoke and mirrors. A lot of them overspend this lifestyle and they not making enough money to provide for the lifestyle that they, you know what I mean, spending for. If you spending 100K a month, but you only make 50K in a month, it don't add up. Eventually, you're not going to be able to afford it. And in order to keep up this image, you're going to do whatever you got to do because you're trying to keep the career going. You don't want the money to stop. That's just where a lot of bad things come in. And sometimes it might not even be of your doing. It'll be of the doing of the people around you, and you don't even really have no knowledge. Just going to touch on one more thing and then wrap it up because this video is getting kind of long. Like I had said originally in the beginning of the video, I lived in Massachusetts. You know what I mean? I got locked up in Massachusetts, arrested in Massachusetts. The cases out there, they don't play. Anybody I know that caught a federal charge in Massachusetts got smoked. Had to do the whole time. They, you know what I mean, couldn't beat the case. You need long money to go at war with the feds in court. And trust me, no disrespect to Herbo, he ain't got that type of money. I honestly hope he be good and he could beat this case, but it looked like his manager did him in. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. I definitely appreciate it. Stay safe. Peace, y'all. To all the people that stayed for this bonus, I appreciate that. To all y'all haters, y'all can suck my... Melvin Flint, you wanted attention and fame? Here you go, little troll. And then the next one is, I mean, he got fired, but not for what you said. Come on, the type of person spread false news and get people killed, that ain't funny. Oh, you mean like DJ Academics did his whole career? Yeah, let's not go there, buddy. Which one is it? One second you're saying he didn't get fired, next second you're saying he did. This is why we can't take haters and trolls seriously. Because at the end of the day, you're a bunch of bitter, jealous haters and get mad when the news isn't what you want to hear. So suck my...